Welcome to Kampala Bible Revelation Church, located at Makerere 1, Okubira Zone. Pastor Hani Mutukiriza and other servants of God welcome you to a ministry based on the Word of God. We have a covenant with God for placement and multiplication according to Ezekiel 37 verse 26 to 28. Welcome to our Sunday services, which impact believers with transformational revelations from the Word of God. Our Thursday midweek service is a series of teachings equipping believers with practical skills from the Word of God. Testimonies of God's goodness abound. You can also join our Doers of the Word Bible Institute, where God's children have been ground into God's Word and empowered with a practical approach to transformation, both spiritually and physically, totally free of charge. We are located at Makerere 1, Mukubira Zone, near Makerere Business Institute, along Sapolokagwa Road. You are welcome.
The rain of the Spirit on the seed. There's a very important fact that we need to see: the relationship between the seed and the rain. Since we're looking at the rain of the Spirit on the seed, because somehow, somewhere it has to do with us. Amen? When did God talk about seed for the first time? This is in Genesis chapter 1, when God talked about seed for the first time. Genesis chapter 1 and verse 12. And the earth brought forth grass, and herb yielding seed after his kind, and the tree yielding fruit, whose seed was in itself after his kind. And God saw that it was good. Praise the Lord. This is the first time God is talking about seed. And this seed here is the natural seed. The beans, the granuts, the rice, wheat, all those seeds, jackfruit. This is natural seed. We want to call it natural seed. It's part of nature. Jesus talked about this natural seed in John chapter 12. The reason I'm bringing up this is, let's first of all see the natural seed before we go to the rain of the Spirit. Let's first of all look at the natural seed and its relationship with rain, because that will give us good understanding of the rain of the Spirit. Because if I met one of you to stand up and ask you, what is the rain of the Spirit? That is really tricky. Anyone here has ever seen the rain of the Spirit? What does it rain like? You know, does it rain spirit? And so, did I say John chapter 12? Are you in verse 24? Jesus here was talking about a natural seed, though he was using it to teach something else, all right? He said, verily, verily, or truly, truly, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat. Now, that's a natural seed. It's a corn of wheat. Except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abides alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruits. This is a natural seed. All right? He has said when it falls into the ground, it dies. We'll talk about that next Sunday, I'm sure. This dying thing. Because as far as I'm concerned, if a dog dies, I don't see how it brings forth much fruit. Do you see how? No. When a dog dies, it has died. Actually, you better bury it away and forget all about it. So, anyway, Jesus here is talking about a natural seed. Have you seen that? That these natural seeds, when they fall into the ground, something happens. They die and they bring much fruit. Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 37, this is Paul talking by the Holy Spirit. He said, and that which thou sowest, Thou sowest not that body that shall be, but bare grain. It may chance of wheat. Are you seeing that? So he's talking about a natural seed. Or of some other grain. Jesus talked about a corn of wheat. Now even Paul saying, it may chance of wheat. It may be it's a corn of wheat. Or some other grain. Whatever it is. Then he said, 38, he says, but God giveth it a body as it has pleased him. And to every seed, his own body. So there are those seeds which God has to determine what kind of body to give. Then there are those seeds he has already ordained what kind of body to have. You see that? But still he's talking about natural seed. So even in the natural seed, God is involved somewhere. Have you seen that? And even in the natural seed, God is involved somewhere. Even in the natural seed. The natural seed. Talk about granuts and maize and name it. Natural as they are, God is involved in their naturality. When it comes to being sown into the ground and coming up again, God is involved there. In Isaiah 30, that the scripture which you have on your handouts, it says, then shall he give the rain of thy seed, that thou shalt sow the ground withal. Don't you think he's talking about the natural seed here? And bread of the increase of the earth, and shall be fat and plenteous. In that day shall thy cattle feed in large pastures. So God is telling us that the natural seed, actually one time Jesus gave a parable and he said, the kingdom of God is like a mustard seed, which is the least of all seeds. It's so small. But once it falls into the ground, it will grow into a huge tree and all the birds of the field will come and rest in it. That the kingdom of God is like that. So the natural seed is so connected to natural rain. The natural seed is so connected to natural rain. That you can have a seed. The reason you plant it in soil, in the ground, is because there is water there. Or water will find it there. Then it will grow from there. It cannot be that you just have to put it in the ground and anyhow it will grow. There has to be water. Right? These are natural things, but some of the things we need to take care of. It is not that you just go and put a seed in any soil anywhere. There has to be water for that seed to grow. In other words, you can put a seed in the ground as long as there's no water. It can even be there as long as there's no water. Nothing will change about it. Am I right? Am I right? A seed without water cannot grow. So that's the natural seed. The natural seed is so connected to natural water or rain that without water, that seed will be like it is. Now, there's nothing wrong with a seed. There's nothing wrong with a seed. The seed has everything inside it. If it is to be a tree, everything is right there. But you'll never see any activity inside that seed until there's water. So natural seeds without natural water amounts to nothing. Someone can have a very good seed and say, this seed is very, very good. It produces ABC or maybe tomatoes. But until you'll keep speaking, then nothing will ever change. Until you put that seed where there is water. And by the way, you can grow a plant without soil, but with water, right? So, natural seeds cannot grow without natural water. So, that's the natural seed. But then we find another kind of seed in Genesis. There's some other kind of seed. Very interesting indeed. Go to Genesis chapter 3. There's another kind of seed in Genesis chapter 3 and verse 15. He said, and I'll put, this was God talking to the devil, And he said, I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. Have you seen that? He shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. What kind of seed is this? This serpent's head bruising seed. What kind of seed is this? What do you think? Is this a natural seed? No. This has to be supernatural seed. Anyone here has ever seen a serpent's head? This, which God was talking? No. This has to be something supernatural. But supernatural as it is a seed. Have you seen that? Supernatural as it is a seed. Now, go with me to Galatians chapter 3 and verse 16. The Apostle Paul, by the Holy Spirit, said, now to Abraham and his seed were the promises made. He says not unto seeds, as of many, but as of one, unto thy seed, which is Christ. Wow. So Christ is a what? Jesus Christ is a seed. And this is the seed which God talked about in Genesis chapter 3 and verse 15. So Christ is a supernatural seed. But now, if the principle is natural seeds need natural water, and Christ is also a seed, we want to see whether that same principle applies. And if the same principle applies, then we need to discover who we are. And if we ever discover that we are also seeds, we are in for it. Something huge is coming our way. The devil is a liar. The devil is telling me that Christians, that believers, don't want such explanations. Too long explanations. They don't think that far. The devil is a liar. You are thinking that far in Jesus' name? You are getting what I'm talking about in Jesus' name? And you are understanding in the name of Jesus. So I will not believe what I saw in your faces. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And every believer shouted. So Paul tells us that Christ is also a seed. And remember, the natural seed, until it gets into water, there is no activity. It remains dormant. It is as natural and as useless as every other thing. But once it gets to where water is, something begins. And God gets involved. If Christ is a seed and is not a natural seed, then he's a supernatural seed. Which, if that principle is correct, it must take the supernatural water to let the seed swing into action. Kumbe, what was its work? To bruise the head of the serpent. Not to destroy, to bruise. You know what it means to bruise? To cause wounds to come on. So, if someone is bruised on his head, what does he do? Does he sing? What does he do? If someone is bruised on his head, he cries. If Christ is a seed that came to bruise the head of the serpent, then we want to know whether as a seed he got water to swing into action. Luke 3:21. Hallelujah. Now, when all the people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also, being baptized, they're baptized in what? In water. They're baptized in water. Now, when other people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also, being baptized and praying, the heaven was opened. Kumbe, what comes from the heavens? Rain. Some rain must be coming. Don't forget, he's a seed and he has been baptized in water. But because he's a supernatural seed, being baptized in natural water is not enough. No wonder he's praying. There's something that something else must happen. And as he prayed, the heaven was opened. and the Holy Ghost descended in a bodily shape like a dove upon him. That was dovely rain. Holy Spirit, dovely rain. And the Holy Ghost descended in a bodily shape like a dove upon him. And a voice came from heaven, which said, Thou art my beloved Son. In thee I am well pleased. What was this which was happening to Jesus? It says, and Jesus himself began to be about 30 years of age. This seed, ladies and gentlemen, had been there dormant for how many years? About. So he was most likely above 30. This seed was dormant. No one knew anything about Jesus until something happened. Until this seed got into water. And the heavens opened and water, rain, supernatural rain fell upon him. The reason they tell us about his age is because the Jesus that was before 30 and the Jesus after 30 were two different people. So we discover the natural seed cannot do anything without natural water. And Christ as a seed, supernatural seed, something has happened to it, this seed. It has come into contact with supernatural rain. Now the question is, if this seed came to bruise the head of the serpent, did it happen so? Go with me to Mark. This is just for your confirmation. Mark 1:23, maybe. And there was in the synagogue a man with an unclean spirit. The serpent right there. There is the serpent right there. And there was in the synagogue a man with an unclean spirit, and he cried out. Why did he cry? Something was happening. Saying, let us alone, let us alone. Ah, what has he done? What have we to do with thee, thou Jesus of Nazareth? Art thou come to destroy us? No, I have not come to destroy you. I'm bruising your head. Then the devil said, I know thee, who thou art, the Holy One of God. And Jesus rebuked him, saying, hold your peace and come out of him. What was Jesus doing? He was bruising his head. Come out. Come out. Come out of him. Bruising. Ah, ah, you are, come out. It appears you want to destroy him. No, come out of him. When we cast out devils, we bruise their heads. They can't stand it. It's because you don't know it. So, when did this happen? After Jesus had received supernatural rain. When this happened? After Jesus had received supernatural rain. Just like the natural seed receives natural water, it begins to grow into something miraculous. So, this supernatural seed, Christ received supernatural rain and he began to bruise the head of the serpent. Maybe Mark chapter 5, just one more scripture. Mark chapter 5 from verse 2, quickly. And when he was come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit. Ah, there is the serpent. Who had his dwelling among the tombs, and no man could bind him. That was a real serpent, friends. No, not with chains. Exactly. Because that he had been often bound with fetters and the chains had been plucked asunder by him. Wow. That's a serpent. And the fetters broken in pieces. Neither could any man tame him, because this was not a man anymore. This was a serpent. And always night and day he was in the mountains and in the tombs crying and cutting himself with stones. But when he saw Jesus afar off, when he saw this seed which had been baptized in water, supernatural water, he ran and worshipped him. I love this. And cried with a loud voice and said, what am I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? I adjure thee by God, thou torment me not. What was Jesus doing? He was bruising the head. Come out of him. For he said unto him, come out of the man, thou unclean spirit. Every time he said it, he bruised his head. The serpent's head began to bleed. So, I've given you the natural seed. I've given you the supernatural seed. That these two cannot do anything without natural water and supernatural water. Now, I'm coming to you. Matthew 13 and verse 37. He answered and said unto them, He that soweth the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The good seed are the children of the kingdom. But the tares are the children of the wicked one. The enemy that sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the world, and the reapers are the angels. Who are the children of the kingdom? Who are the good seed? Who are the good seed? One more time. Shout a good hallelujah if the good seed. You are the good seed. You are the good. Yeah, you are weak. You don't know how to pray. The other time you ate the tithe and all that. You are the good seed. Yeah, you fell in sin. You lied somewhere. Some of you even fought. Some of you are even afraid of witchcraft and all that. You are the good seed. Yes, you came this morning with some of you had bad dreams and you woke up on the wrong side of the bed. You are the good seed. You are the good seed. You are the good seed. Pastor, I'm not sure of my tomorrow. You are the good seed. That pastor doesn't know me. He didn't know what I just did yesterday, last night. You are the good seed. You are the good seed. There are so many good seeds in trash. You can find a good seed in a trash can, right? That's a trash can. Where the good seed is. But that seed is good. Whatever that trash can says to that seed cannot change that this is a good seed. You are the good seed. One more time. Now let's go back to our principle. Natural seeds need natural water. This supernatural seed of Christ needed supernatural water. And then it swung into action, right? Just like the natural seed, once there is water, it will swing into action. And God will come in. So was the supernatural seed. Now, if we are the good seed, then we need some good water. If we are the good seed, then we need some good water. So, does this therefore make you to understand that there are so many good seeds among us who have amounted to nothing because there is something missing? Am I right to say so? That there are so many so good seeds among us who actually appear as nothing. They haven't been to anything because something is missing. Something is terribly missing. Actually, when you look at them, they are good seeds, yes, but something is missing. They can't swing into action. They'll be dormant, some of them, for years. So some of them are used to their dormancy. But thank God for this day. Every seed is going to receive some. Every good seed is going to receive good rain upon it. Because it can't be that the principle is going to change. So quickly, let's go to Isaiah 44 and verse 3. Hallelujah. For I will pour water upon him that is thirsty, and floods upon the dry ground. Now that is natural water. Natural ground for natural seed. Then he says, I'll pour my spirit upon your seeds and my blessing upon your offspring. So what is this good seed going to receive? The Spirit of God. What is missing? This spiritual rain, the rain of the Spirit. I'll pour water upon him that is thirsty. Actually, what he meant was, I'll pour my spirit upon your seed. Him that is thirsty. That's the missing link. To drink this water and swing into action. John chapter 7 and verse 37. In the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. What a seed. What a seed. Do you know what it takes? It takes rivers of living water for this seed to do something. Rivers of living water. Then he says, but this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive, the good seed. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. And now he is glorified. He's seated at the right hand of God. So now it's your time to receive the water and begin to swing into action. Someone was wondering, what will it take for me to be promoted? Someone was wondering, what will it take for me to change status? Someone was wondering, what will it take for me, myself, to be doubled, quadrupled? May I tell you what it will take? Receive the spiritual water upon your seed, and things will begin to happen which you never dreamt about. You are a seed. That's why you need water. You are a good seed. That's why you need good water. You are a spiritual seed. That's why you need the Holy Spirit. That's why you need him. Jesus was dormant for 30 years. Why? Because as a seed, he had not yet contacted water. But that after he contacted water, it was no more that Jesus. Something happened. Isn't this the carpenter's son? Isn't he the son of Joseph? This one who used to stay over there, and all the sisters we know and the brothers we know. And is he the one? And they were offended. Why were they offended? Because the guy was in Hygieia. The guy was above. The devils were crying everywhere he went, because they were getting their heads bruised. Miracles, signs, and wonders were happening everywhere. Miracles, signs, and wonders must happen to you too. Amen. Can I hear you say amen? We don't come here to hear what God has done to others. He must do the same to us. Amen. What someone else has received, I must receive also. Amen. I don't hear you believing amen. Amen. Now, what does it take? It takes the Holy Spirit. He said to his disciples, tarry in Jerusalem. Don't go anywhere. Wait for the water. Wait for the rain. It's coming. And Acts chapter 2, there was a great, mighty rushing wind. What do you call that? And it filled the whole place where they were. And there were all enough of these nominal believers. Enough of these. They pray for 5 minutes. They give a tithe. They don't preach the gospel. No one knows that they are born again where they work from. They are saved from the inside. Enough of that. Some activity must be seen right now. Amen. We want to see some activity. I've said, amen. Let the Spirit of God come in and let him take charge. Amen. Without the Holy Spirit, you were as dormant as Jesus was before he contacted the spiritual realm. You were as dormant. No one knows anything about you. But you go to church all the time. Every Sunday you come to church. Some are even ushers. Some are even in the choir. I don't know. I know. You are a seed that need water. Jesus said this water must flow like rivers for that seed to amount to anything. Simply telling you that Jesus has a seed, rivers of water are flowing out of him. The blind were seeing. The lame were walking. The sick were healed. The lepers were cleansed. The dead were raised. Why doesn't it happen now? Why? Bless his holy name. Someone is afraid of witchcraft and comes to this church. Someone comes to this church and is afraid of witchcraft. You can imagine. You can imagine that. That someone comes to this church and is afraid of witchcraft. No. You are a good seed. All you need is good water, the Spirit of God. You can know when you have the Spirit of God, because you'll swing into action. There will be activity. All that there is right now is dormancy. The use of the routine. You wake up morning, you brush your teeth, you bathe maybe, you put on cloth, you go about your daily business, you are dormant. The reason you are dormant is because you were seed and you need water to swing into action. You don't need papers. Oh, that's dormancy. You don't need any qualification. That's dormancy. You are still dormant with all your degrees. Withstanding, you are as dormant as a dead dog. Until the Spirit, have you seen it? When he was baptized in water, he said, no, this is not the water I must receive. He prayed, Lord, open the heavens. And as he prayed, the heavens opened and water for the Holy Spirit came upon him. That's what we need right now. Right now. I'm telling you, some of you are young people. Most of you are young people. I can't see how you miss out on this. I can't see how you begin to rely on your intellect and common sense. As long as you're following common sense, you are common. You are trying to be groomed. You follow manner etiquettes, and those things don't work. You are dormant until you get the Spirit of God upon that seed. That seed is dormant. Some of you don't even know who you are. He said, he gives it a body as he pleases. Once that seed has contacted water, he gives it a body as he pleases. That Jesus, before he contacted water, and that Jesus, after he contacted water, are two different Jesuses. And that's what must happen to me. Amen. That's what must happen to me. Amen. Pastor, they just hate me at my place of work. No, you need water. They hate you because you're dormant. You are what you're not supposed to be. You are supposed to be the leader. I've always told you, there is a lady who came from this church and was given a job somewhere. And she was a sweeper. She was a what? Just to mop the place. The moment she got in that place, a sweeper, the MD of that organization, big organization, yeah, there's something about you. You mean you came out to it? Did you have any formal education? She said, no education. You know some form of English? No, very little, I don't. Hey! And from that time, whatever the MD had to do or to decide, he had to call the sweeper to consult her. And whatever she spoke to him came to pass. A sweeper. Time came, the MD said, I'm ashamed that you are here sweeping. You ought not to be sweeping. Maybe, can't you try some photocopying? Because I also want to promote you and give you more salary, because I don't want to lose you. The MD, the lady comes from this church. So she said, maybe you teach me how to operate a photocopy. He said, now you look. So she has to go by color. This is a green button. This is a yellow button. This does and this. So she went by colors because she didn't know how to read English. But there was something about that woman that the MD needed her. She was indispensable. That's what you need. What do you think was different about this woman? It was the Holy Spirit upon her life. And that's what we need today, right now. With all your qualifications, withstanding, for heaven's sake, you need the Holy Spirit. Pastor, I'm a good mathematician, and no figures just escape me. You ain't serious. There's a serpent with its head which has better mathematics than you. There is a serpent with better mathematics than you. Amen. And you cannot bruise its head without this water. Jesus could not bruise. Jesus never dared it until he contacted water from heaven. Then he said, where are you? Come out of them. You're bruising us. I said, come out. Oh, I bruise your head again and it bleeds. Oh, it chops off. I'll chop it off. That's what the church is waiting for.
Welcome to Kampala Bible Revelation Church, located at Makerere 1, Okubira Zone, Pastor Hanning Mutukiriza and other servants of God welcome you to a ministry based on the Word of God. We have a covenant with God for placement and multiplication according to Ezekiel 37 verse 26 to 28. Welcome to our Sunday services, which impact believers with transformational revelations from the Word of God. Our Thursday midweek service is a series of teachings equipping believers with practical skills from the Word of God. Testimonies of God's goodness abound. You can also join our Doers of the Word Bible Institute, where God's children have been ground into God's Word and empowered with a practical approach to transformation, both spiritually and physically, totally free of charge. We are located at Makerere 1, Mukubira Zone, near Makerere Business Institute, along South Lokagwa Road. You are welcome.